Give you four for it, because I got to cut off the last bit, and my customers want uncut.
Fuck that, man. The last part is the best. You drive down six times, and bam, all major jacks right into the big black.
Don't deal. Blackjack clips. Pops, I got ethics here.
Oh, yeah, when did that start? Come on, Lenny. This is what people want to see, and you know it.
Clear it off to somebody else.
Lenny, I got expenses. I'm going to get my rig fixed. Look at it. It's a little over the head.
Anyway.
Give me six at least. This is a good clip, man. It's so pumping.
Well, first part's okay. Better than the usual soaps you bring.
Now, that's all. You know why I don't have any choice.
Yeah, sure. Like, this low-grade shit here. Some girl in a fight with her boyfriend. It's a test pattern. Nothing happens. I'm snoring.
Lenny, you're always telling me, bring you street life, bring you real life, that one man's mundane and desperate existence is another man's technicolor.
I said that?
Many times. It's a direct quote.
I'll take it for five. And you'll make out okay, because in this case, it's pure cream. You don't have to cut anything back to wear.
Yeah, that's for sure. Okay.
What else you got?
Don't use your mother like you usually do. Yeah, you do, asshole.
Go ahead, caller. You're on the air.
My name's
name Dwayne. I got newly resolution for the police. You know what I'm saying? Hey, yo, 5-0. Better get down with 2K.
2K, Dwayne. Help us out. What is that?
2K. You know what I'm saying? The big 2000. Coming up tomorrow night. I was the old and with the new. See, for the man, don't know what's good news. You know what I'm saying? I mean, he like keep it the way it is, but we gonna take it and make it new. Make it our own. I mean, history gonna start right here. You know what I'm saying? Right now.
Dwayne.
Hey, I wanna give a shout out to Boo.
You're on the air, Lori.
If you read the Bible, Mark, you know that there won't be another 1,000 years. Right now, we're in the last days, as we're told in the book of Revelation.
The last days? You mean the coming of the apocalypse, right? The rapture.
You only have to look at the signs. There are wars and rumors of wars.
Now, just so the rest of us know how much time is left, when is the rapture supposed to hit? Exactly. Is it midnight New Year's Eve?
That's right.
Now, is that midnight L.A. time or Eastern Standard Time or what? I mean, what time zone has got in anyway?
I pray for you all.
You gotta move your eyes slower next time. Much, much slower. Like you're making love with your eyes, okay?
Wait, let me get this straight. You're gonna pay me $200 to put on a hairnet and bang some beautiful babe. I don't know, I gotta think about that.
Let's get you wired up. I hope this axle grease you got in your hair doesn't screw up the spit receptors.
What is all this squid shit anyway?
Superconducting quantum interference device, squid. The receptor rate when putting on your head sends a signal to the recorder. We call it being wired, but there's no wire. And you gotta keep the recorder close, like 5-6 feet away max, in your jacket pocket by the bed, or wherever you're gonna close escrow. You know what I mean?
Yeah, right.
Got a half hour of tape so I can give you some lead-in to the main event. But don't wait too long, because I don't want to be going out for popcorn.
Don't worry, you won't.
Got it.
Yeah, no problem.
You look great. You look beautiful.
Hey, come back.
You all right? Need help? Sweetie, you're doing good.
No.
Lenny. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, baby. Are you okay?
It's being called the party of the century, but it may be the biggest party ever. No one's seen preparations like this, but preparations require care and insurance. And the LAPD is one insurance company that doesn't want accidents. The bodies of two men found when he was coming into the Hollywood Freeway have been identified as rap star Miracle One and band member James Holden, known to fans as Replay. Both men were shot repeatedly in what police are characterizing as an execution-style killing. The body of an unidentified woman was found with them, also shot numerous times. Police earlier said that the killings appear to be gang-related. With his band, Prophets of Light, Jericho One's outspoken political stance and violent lyrics have stirred nationwide controversy. Meanwhile, astrologers have been busy making predictions for the coming century. Some of their fortune-telling is indeed incredible. Muammar Gaddafi will be awarded the Nobel Peace Prize. Turkey will make reparations to Armenia. By the year 2025, there will be a second woman president.
The technology was developed for the feds to replace the body wire, and now it's gone black market.
That's right, so this conversation's not taking place, okay?
Damn right it's not.
Good.
So, do I get the deck from you?
I'll get your deck in my car, since my thing is the software.
Clips, right? Clips, right.
Now listen, I want you to know what we're talking about here, okay? not like TV, only better. This is life. It's a piece of somebody's life. It's pure and uncut, straight from the cerebral cortex. I mean, you're there, you're doing it, you're seeing it, you're hearing it, you're feeling it.
What kind of things, exactly?
Exactly anything. It's whatever you want, whoever you want to be, okay? I mean, you want to go skiing without leaving your den? You can, but I'm assuming that a guy like you, you want to go skiing, you fly to Aspen. That's not what you're interested in here. It's about the stuff that you can't have, right? The forbidden fruit, Like running into a liquor store with a .357 Magnum in your hand, feeling the adrenaline pumping through your veins, huh? Or, you see that guy over there with the drop-dead Filipino girlfriend? You just have to be that guy for 20 minutes, the right 20 minutes. I can make it happen, and you won't even tarnish your wedding ring. Sounds good. I can get you what you want. I can get you anything. You just have to talk to me. You have to trust me. You can trust me. Because I'm your priest. I'm your shrink. I am your main connection to the switchboard of the souls. I'm the magic man. Santa Claus is the subconscious. You say you think you can have it. You want a girl? You want two girls? I mean, I don't know what you're thinking of stuff here, what you're curious about. You want a guy. Maybe you want to be a girl. Hey, think of that. Be a girl. See what that feels like. I mean, maybe you want a nun to tell you. It's all doable.
Talk to me about costs here.
Okay, now before we get into numbers, I want you to try a taste, okay? I got a deck with me.
Right here.
Step into my office. You're just an 18-year-old girl taking a shower. Are you beginning to see the possibilities here?
Hey, listen, what do you get to report car? 200? 250? I'll pay 250 right now.
got the cash.
No, I'm going to write you a check if that's okay.
See ya.
Okay, okay. I totally respect that call. I mean, I live on cash. They'll take my check inside. I can see you press for time. Just give me 2 minutes. Here.
You can keep my watch for collateral. It's a Rolex. I'll be right back. 2 minutes. 2 minutes.
Son of a bitch!
So what happened to you by this time?
See, Lenny, you packed your piece. You could make the guy see sense. Bobby, turn this up on my watch.
Now you watch us take it all, and then you'll understand our pain. We make you the rat that crawl through the cracks. You love that red, white, blue, but you hate the black, black, black. And you try to make me think I did this to myself when the drugs I smoked and the guns I took both came from your shelf.
Government's been tried, you know, every fucking hairstyle, fucking bubblegum flavors, you know, breakfast cereal, every type of fucking, you know what I mean? What are we gonna do, man? How are we gonna make another 1,000 years, for Christ's sake? I'm telling you, man, it's over. We used it all up.
So, Lenny, what's this week's sad story?
Oh, they jerked my wheels, do you believe it? I mean, it's outrageous, the computer errors the banks are making lately. Have you noticed?
No, actually, I haven't noticed because I make my payments. So, Max told you, how's the PI business?
Sucks. But as soon as I get this new logo...
Shut up a second, I'm gonna
kill it. Do you have any leads?
Inadequate
security available to him. You know, he's
just not to have those kind of things. Why is he a scumbag,
Lenny? You know who left Lenny for him. Faith left
Lenny for him? Don't say Faith. You know, you use the F word around Lenny, it triggers a mob in display, and you got tranquilized.
Well, he says that this is a gang-related incident.
Let me know I've lost a friend. A man of great courage. Which is more than I could say to most of us.
Lenny, if you're riding, let's go.
Okay, let's go.
Driving Mr. Lenny.
It's gonna be a big night. Can't you feel it? The energy in the air, there's money to be made, dreams to sell.
Please to peddle.
See, that is so unenlightened. I sell experiences. The way I see it, I'm performing a humanitarian service. I probably save lives.
I want to hear this part.
Look, everybody needs to take a walk to the dark end of the street sometime.
It's what we are. Now, the rest are out of line. The streets are a war zone. Sex can kill you. So, to sit on the troves, get what you need, almost as good as the real thing, a lot safer.
Face it, you sell porno to wire here.
Harsh! Harsh and untrue. My clients are professionals, they're people with taste. Some of them are even celebrities.
Yeah, what celebrities?
The guy from the news.
He does the weather.
That counts. Hey, you passed Messianica.
That would imply I'm not taking my Messianica.
Yeah, but it's the biggest way to get to the club.
I gotta get to the club, I got business there, I'm meeting people. Mace, you're my friend. I need you, plus I'm giving you 25% of what I make today.
You know, this may be a hard concept for you, but friends don't have to pay your friends.
Faith is singing that night.
Should have known. I pulled 12 hours. I gotta get some sleep. Now I got one last pickup at the St. James Club. They got a taxi stand. You can get your cab. It'll take you wherever you want to go.
A taxi? Well, someone might see me.
Damn it, Lenny, you made me late.
Take care. What's your pickup's name?
Fumitz.
Commissioners. Sure, whatever. See, since you sit kind of my career, I don't even have to call you, sir. It's one of life's small pleasures.
Aren't you peddling your wares a little far from your usual cutter?
No, I was invited here by a close friend, Mr. Fumitsu. See, he's right over there.
I don't like disappointments, Nero. You know what disappoints me.
Your sex life? Excuse me. Mr. Fumitsu. Konbanwa. Konbanwa. Brendan Nero, BLS Limousine Security Service. I've arranged for one of our very finest drivers, Lornette Mason, to take care of you this evening. He's a bonded security specialist. He's trained in defensive combat. And, of course, the car is bulletproof and fully armored. I'll just be coming along to complete a routine periodic driver evaluation. With your permission, of course. We do it to ensure that our VIP clients such as yourself always treat us honored guests.
Good evening, Mr. Knudsen. So please watch your hand. Excuse me, Mr. Nero. Excuse me, sir. What the fuck are you doing?
Come in with.
You will not live to see them all.
Drive on.
Just what they could say. Are you a cop?
No.
Have you ever been wired?
Wired.
The latest technology.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that is so beautiful. You gotta take a look at this, okay? Yeah. You gotta love it.
You have more.
I have more.
You have more?
Believe me, I have more.
Okay.
Hey, careful on the jack, it's Armani.
You angry?
I told you no wiring this shit in my car. You're a fuck.
In L.A.? Are you crazy?
Hey, can we talk to the hair like two rational adults?
That'd be no. Okay, you got my attention. This is cutting off the circulation of my head here. Do you mind? Maisie.
It's cool, it's not 2 seconds.
Hey, Maisie, some characteristic behavior for you besides water in our veins, super chill.
You pushed me too far, Lenny. You made me lose it in front of a client. I could get fired.
Are we still friends?
I don't know, Lenny. You see, friendship is more than one person constantly doing favors for another.
Know that.
I don't hustle my friends.
Hey,
you should suck people along with your schemes, your scams, and your slick act.
We're still buddies, aren't we?
Don't just be using the time that I'm talking to be thinking about what you're going to say next. You listen?
Yeah.
Lenny, your ass is always broke. You go from one score to the next, and you're getting strung out. You don't even see it. It's your brain, so you do whatever the hell you want with it. But not on my watch, you understand me? I got a child, I got rent, and I got an ex-husband doing hard time who doesn't send me a dime of support. I'm just trying to hold on here.
I know you wouldn't be saying all this if you didn't care about me. Thanks, mate, really.
You're getting out with the Mitchell, and that's the end. I'll get you to the tip list in 10 minutes, sir. There's some for the inconvenience.
I've changed my plans. Your supervisor, Mr. Nero, has recommended an excellent club called the Retinal Fetish. I believe it's on La Cienega.
Yes. Enjoy your evenings.
Hey, Mace. I need to say, okay? Okay, come on. Excuse us.
This right off a dead dog's ball.
I've already got everything I need from you, Lenny. Thanks.
Cut it out, Philo.
Too bad about your guy Jericho, man. It's a tough break. You lost your golden goose.
Try showing some respect sometime. Man, he's an important artist.
Important for your label, which no doubt is why you're in mourning. Well, don't worry. His records will sell out. Now he's dead, you'll make out.
Always do.
Faith, can I talk to you for 1 second?
It's not a good idea right now, Lenny.
I just gotta talk to you for 1 second, okay?
About what?
think that'd be between me and Faith, wouldn't it?
Funny, Lenny, I don't feel anything between you and Faith. You see, that's your problem, Lenny. You assume too much. You assume there's something and there's nothing. You assume that you have a life. In fact, you're just peddling pieces of other people's lives and the broken parts of your own.
Faith!
Wait, get into the car.
Faith! Call me, okay? Faith! Call me!
Lenny the loser.
Leave him alone, Philo, okay?
Just he shouldn't be talking to him. He shouldn't be talking to anybody. I mean, not with everything that's going on.
Are too goddamn paranoid. You know that, Philo?
Paranoia is just reality on a finer scale.
When?
Tonight. Well, I haven't seen that girl in months. What the fuck would she know? Who knows what's going on in that whore's head?
Well, she used to be your best friend.
What, Iris? Uh-huh. You're really running out of excuses to come around, aren't you?
I know you, Faith. You're afraid of something. What's going on?
Just let it alone, Lenny. It'll take care of itself.
It's Gam, isn't it? This guy's poison, Faith. You've got to listen to me. He's got you walled in on all sides and uses the wire too much. He gets up on tape, not on you.
And that's a good one coming from you.
Why don't you just split, huh?
Because I don't want to.
Would you love him, Faith? I don't think so. And to him, you're just some kind of possession. You're like a Ferrari. Just something to show the other guys.
Yeah. He has his uses too, you know.
What? He's gonna record you on his label?
He might. You never know, right?
Faith. Listen, I watched you create yourself out of nothing but a goddamn cruise missile. Targeted on making it. And you will.
I know I will.
It's you up on that stage. It's not him. You don't need him.
Lenny, you have to get out of here. If Philo catches you, he's gonna hurt you.
I'm already hurting.
No, I'm serious. He's acting crazy. He's doing way too much playback. He's gotten completely paranoid. He's such a control freak now. He's even paying Max to follow me around.
Max? You're kidding.
Yeah, for about a month now.
Jesus.
Look, Lenny, just stay away from Philo. And stay away from me. Stop trying to rescue me. Those days are over. I'm a big girl now. I changed. Stop trying to save me. I don't need saving. Just give up on me!
I just want to make sure you're all right.
You know one of the ways that movies are still better than playback? Because the music comes up, there's credits, and you always know when it's over. It's over!
You were great.
Hey, man, I know what you're thinking.
Tell me about your new gig.
I was gonna tell you. It's just a job, man. I feel like shit about it.
Should feel like shit.
I do feel like shit, okay? Hey, you introduced me to that prick Gant.
I introduced me to Faith, too, because it means a moment that changed from my past.
Questionable move, definitely, given the historical perspective. Anyway, look, the way I had it figures, I can take the prick's money, you wouldn't believe it, no charge for me. And I make sure that Faith is okay at the same time. Keep an eye on her for you, okay? Which you can't do without getting your fingers bent the wrong way back. See? And I'm busted, man. I need the money. This way it does you and me both some good.
Fairly twisted logic, man. It's even for you. Hey, got a job.
I got a job.
Okay, I'm sorry. You got a job. That's great.
I got a job.
Hey, listen. You gotta stay on him, okay? Watch it for me. Please.
I'm on her.
Okay.
Take it easy, all right?
Hey, wait a minute. I recognize you. You're Wade Beamer, right? Running back for the Rams, 96-97. Am I right?
Yeah. That's right.
Yeah, so you play, man. I mean, you were good. Really good. I mean, it looked like a fucking freight train. So, what happened, man? Injuries or what? Bullshit politics, man. It's always politics. Like this thing in here, like he's paying you to tune me up. I mean, I can pay you more than that. You see what I mean? I can write you a check right now.
I gotta go.
Okay, cash. Cash. Here's everything I have on me. Oh, look, what do you say? How about a Rolex?
I got a real one.
Come on, it won't hurt too bad. It's nothing personal. Just 1 second. Just 1 second, please. It's my jacket. It's really expensive. It's just not the eyes.
You're bleeding.
Some jerk puked down the stairs and I slipped. I should sue. Came back for me.
I came back to pick up my client.
No, you came back for me. I gotta lie down. Macy, please, in the back.
Piece of work, Lenny Nero. You just calmly backstroking along in a big toilet bowl and somehow you never let it touch you. I mean, between working vice and your current so-called occupation, you must have seen every kind of perversion. But you're just like some Teflon man. You still come out this goofball romantic.
It's my sword and my shield, Mason.
Say?
Oh, nothing.
such a meeting right now. Go! Go!
Sure, it's real.
Oh. Well, I lost my appetite for about a year. Want to take a look?
Hell no, I don't fool with that.
You all right?
Yeah.
You okay?
No, I'm all right.
All right. Let's work. He used to be good at this shit. Let's play it down. What's the perp doing? He used to be a fucking cop, okay? Now but it's a fucking murder.
What's he doing?
Okay, he stalks her. And, he rapes her. And he does it.
He records it. It's a thrill kill, right? He wants to see it again and again and again.
He records himself raping and killing.
But at the same time, he's sending a signal to her.
So she feels what he feels while he's inside her. The thrill, while he's killing her. Sent to her, heightening her fear, which in turn heightens the turn on for him. Makes us your own death, feeds off reaction. He records it all, everything.
And gives it to you.
Yeah. Wants to share.
Of course he wants to share, man. That's his deal. He needs an audience. It's a sick puppy.
Why me?
Because you're the magic man, Lenny. You make dreams happen, don't you? If it's got something to do with the water, sooner or later it washes up on your beach.
I've never dealt in blackjacks. Never. Everybody knows that.
Oh, come on, he's just skull fucking you, buddy, all right? He just wants to get a reaction out of you. He wants to make you do something that you do not want to do.
No, hell, maybe he just figures Lenny will appreciate what he's created. It's the dark end of the street. How do you like it now?
Just back off.
No, this guy is one of your squidhead contacts. He's somebody that you know, Lenny.
The problem with that is, Mace, Lenny knows everybody.
Let's take the tape to the cops.
No. No. Something crucified me.
Let's see, so this wire freak gets to keep running around, huh?
Lenny's right. The police will think he's the perp. Or they'll go through his client list and they'll ruin his life.
Such as it is.
I'm gonna call my buddies at Honda Center, right? I'm gonna tell them Iris was a friend of mine and that would have put me in the loop.
I'll get the forensics and all that shit, okay? Get some sleep. I'll call you when I get something. Relax! Lenny! Keep moving, man. Somebody's thinking about you a whole lot.
By to give you some bad news, okay? An old friend of mine's been murdered. Remember Iris?
How the fuck did you get out there?
Sean.
Tell you what, just for you. Make a deal. I'll just stay here. Make she's so unhappy, and she wants to leave, she can go. And I'll let her decide. Faith always knows what she wants. Don't you believe? See? Hands up. Tell you something else. I'll tell you this, you fuck. If she says she stays, you go. You crawl back in your little copper and tell her enough.
I've made my choice, Lenny.
Get him out. Get him out.
Fucking crazy, Faith! You're fucking crazy! Come in, Faith!
Understands you did it for him, right?
He doesn't even know what's going on. Leave him alone!
Not to leave him alone if he'd stop coming around and you would just stop firing at him.
Dead hooker, handcuffs, penetration. Some cops are lazy, and they know nobody gives a shit about a dead hooker. I mean, they're roadkill, right? So they'll come in. I'll take some pictures, and I'll make some jokes. I'll just shrug it off like it's a random kill. It's a trick gone wrong. It's a kind you never saw.
But that doesn't add, does it?
No, it doesn't. No,
because Iris said she knew somebody was after her. That is not random.
If they get me, I know.
She said they. If they get me, they. Which means this whole, like, random
sex killer thing is bullshit, which means somebody whacked her for a reason.
So this guy's not a psycho?
No, he's a psycho. To do what's on that tape, he's not a well-adjusted human being. But that's the
escape. Okay, Lenny. Put it down. Then I'll check on you tomorrow.
Oh, you want to rub my neck? My shoulder's a little sore.
Okay.
All right,
come here.
Yeah, oh yeah. How's Xander?
He's fine.
I miss
him. Misses you too. I'm real sorry about being so hard on you earlier. It's just that I see you getting sucked into this deeper and deeper right now.
Miss, come on. I know you still love me.
What do you have in mind?
Hey, last day of the world, you spend it in bed?
What's up, man?
Not a whole hell of a lot, man. Just been saying words over Jericho. That's just running pretty high down here, man, I'm telling you.
Faith okay?
Yeah. She's leaving the camp. I got a book real quick. Iris checked into the region last night under a false name. She paid cash.
Yeah, looks like she was hiding out.
Yep. So, heard you dropping a gant last night. Another slick money move, huh?
Oh, he's in there somehow. I don't know how. Just stick with the Faith, okay?
No worries, bro.
So where are we going?
Anywhere.
You're acting strange. What's going on?
What?
We'll talk about it in the car. There's a box of tapes. Oh, shit.
What's the matter?
His tie doesn't go blue.
Lenny, would you relax? We're not being followed. Stop being so paranoid.
The guy had a knife to my throat in my living room.
Relax, he might be mad at, okay?
One unbelievable piece of eye fuck.
Just give you our criticism, Tick. What can you tell me about the wearer?
That guy's fucked up.
We know that, Tick.
No, I mean the killer's got some kind of distortion in the visual cortex. Look, the color and the grayscale values are all messed up, like colorblindness, TP period ratios. There could be some kind of tumor or brain lesion or something, some kind of trauma. Whoever's doing this is using a box to split the signal so that...
You ever make a box like that?
Yeah, a few, but I can't see the gear well enough to see if it's mine. I don't like this. This is not good. She's cutting awfully close to me. She was just here, man.
Who was just here?
Iris, would you pay attention
Wait,
to me?
Iris was here?
She was here the other night. She was shaking like a junkie. Said she wanted me to make a copy of some clip.
What clip? What was it?
I don't know. She wouldn't let me see it. She said I wouldn't want to see it. Said she was going to give it to you to hold for her. Like insurance or something.
She never gave me a tape.
Think back to what she said. And
she came into the bar. She was crying. She wanted to go out to my car.
Can you go out to your car for me? There's something you have to see. There's
something about my car.
Something in your car.
I'm just gonna get my car back. The place is closed.
Shut the fuck up.
Give him the tape.
It's in my case. I'm gonna open my case.
Facing us, so we can see it.
Take it and turn it loose, okay?
Yeah. Absolutely.
gonna go any second.
And get your address. We gotta keep moving.
What's up?
Xander, we're going to Aunt Cecile's house. We want the fireworks from over there, okay?
Oh, Mom.
Oh, Mom, come on, boy. Cha-cha, come on.
Come on, Xander. We're going for a ride. Hey, come on, buddy.
I want to know what's going on.
Get in the car, Cecile.
What's going on now?
Now.
Sorry, this has to be your first playback. It's all right. Keep your eyes closed, or you'll see double.
Thank you.
hands off of the car. Don't move. You're too much.
Suppose you pulled us over because you had suspects fitting our description in the area. Is that what you're going to tell me?
Well, what was the description? Two black males in the car? Yeah, right. I heard that before. Well, you know what? You pulled over the wrong black male tonight, officer. What is it? Steckler. Officer Steckler. Because I'm that 800-pound gorilla in your midst, fucker. I make more money in a day than you make in a whole year. And my lawyer loves spending my money dragging sorry-ass Aryan RoboCop fuckers like you into court. Get a man down on the ground with no probable cause, man. Fuck you.
Shut the fuck up.
Oh.
Shut up and get back over there.
Motherfucker, kick me, man.
Step right.
You're that rapper, Pew. Jericho One. You're the one that's been getting all the gangbangers together, going downtown, forming citizen groups, trying to rape the LAPD over a cheese grater.
Yeah, that's right. And you're going to be in my next song. It's going to be called Robo Steckler. It's all about a cop who met his worst nightmare. A nigga with enough political juice to smudge his ass like a stage bug. You're going to be famous, fucker.
I don't think so.
Swallowing us all.
Yeah, I know. Max,
are you there? Meet me at Tix in half an hour, and Lenny, don't get pulled over, okay?
You know what this tape could do with the gun out.
Yeah, I've got a pretty good idea.
We will find it now. See? The LAPD just flat out executed Jericho. Jesus. Maybe they ought to see.
Maybe, but tonight's probably not the best night. Miss, come on. We're rolling. Well, I don't think those cops did Iris. I think whoever Iris was wearing before killed her.
Why?
To break the trail. If those cops had gotten hold of her, they'd have beat it out of her who she was wearing for, and then gone after them, too. Our killer is running as scared as we are, which makes him really dangerous, judging by how scared I am.
Is he dead?
No, but his frontal lobes are like two runny eggs. They put an amplifier in line to boost the signal, and it fries his brain. Tick! It's Lenny! Hey, Tick, come on! Come on, Tick! This guy is totally cut off from the outside world.
How long does it last?
Those two psycho cops run a slash and burn, man, to find the tape and cover their tracks. You know, since Tix is a known duplicator, they want to find out what he knows, like if copies were made or who might have wired up Iris. It doesn't even get investigated as a homicide since he's technically alive.
Yeah, that's right, he's technically alive.
Seems a little sophisticated for them. These are not subtle guys.
There's more to this whole thing than you think, Mace.
What do you mean?
All I'm saying is, you don't know how high up the food chain this thing goes. I heard stuff.
What stuff?
You know, I heard stuff. Smoke, rumors. I've heard stuff. For stuff about a death squad. A group of guys, cops, loyal to the Hardline School. Guys have had too many years at City Hall, and review boards and the goddamn media pissing down their necks, suspending cops right and left, tying their hands, while out of the other side of their mouths, these same people are screaming, save us, do something, you fucking morons, crime is totally out of control.
Bullshit, Max, it's conspiracy paranoia.
The issue isn't whether you're paranoid, Lenny, I mean, look at this shit. The issue is whether you're paranoid enough.
Christ.
Exactly, get religion, man. I love you like my own blood, Lenny, but don't walk near me in public right now, right?
The only car we gotta play is to take. Get it to the media.
That's right, yeah, blow it open.
Hey, Mace, Lenny, no disrespect, but you run that on 11 o'clock news by midnight, you got the biggest riot in history, they'll see the fucking smoke in Canada.
So what the hell are you saying, Max? Pretend it didn't happen?
I say that.
It happened. The LAPD executed one of the most important black men in America. Who the fuck are you to try to bury it?
Trying to rank the LAPD over a cheese grater?
Fine. You want blood running waist deep in the storm drains, then go do it. 200,000 gangbangers will spread like a wave through this city and burn it to the fucking ground, Mace. And as soon as the fire starts, the street cops will start capping off anything that moves. It'll be an all-out war, and you know it.
I don't think so.
Well, maybe it's time for a war.
Well, you really want that on your head, Mace?
Huh?
Really?
Whoever did Iris did take is the same sick wirehead shit. It's the same reason to burn the trail. Now Faith knows anything about this. And she does.
Somebody's gonna kill Faith.
Yeah, you're not ready. No.
Here to help you.
All right, I'll talk to you alone.
Mace is in this.
Tell us.
Faith.
Philo, he's gotten obsessed with playback. He's a total wire trip junkie. He's such a control freak now. He's been having people followed. He's recording his business partner's phone calls. He's wiring up people left and right. Philo and Jericho weren't getting along. He was afraid Jericho was going to dump him, but he wasn't sure. So he starts with the surveillance. A couple of nights ago, he wires up Iris and he sends her and the other girl, Diamanda, over to Jericho's table.
Hi, baby. Hi. My name is Iris.
Look at her present. So beautiful.
So that night, Iris calls up crying. She's freaking out. She comes over and she plays the tape. Philo loses it. He can't believe the disaster she's gotten him into. He's afraid the cops are going to beat it out of her who she's been working for and then come looking for help.
Lenny, just go public with the tape. Save himself that.
If it got out that he had his own artist under surveillance, he'd lose all his other acts and it'd be over for him. Some money. Huh? He tells her to check into a hotel under an assumed name until he can figure out what to do.
He figured out what to do on this.
What, you think he killed her?
Killed her, knew right where she was because he put her there.
What a nightmare.
I don't know who the fuck she is, but Elaine, let's go.
Bob, listen, man. I was wondering how you wanted me to work tonight at the bar eventually. You want me downstairs at the party or up to the suite?
Lenny.
Leave here with me right now.
Come on.
Talk about that later.
No, man, I really need to know. Upstairs, downstairs, where you gonna be?
Where the fuck are you waiting? Come on, get him, go! I just say this once, baby, okay? So we talk about that later.
Oh, okay, man, I'm cool. I'm sorry, man. Hey, wait, go for a pass, bro.
Move it! Move!
party.
Wait. I'm going to take her out to the suite.
No problem.
You going to have a glass of champagne? Or six. See you up there in a bit. Happy rain in the new year.
I live for the moment.
Pussy whipped sorry ass motherfucker. Ow!
Take it easy.
So where are they now?
He's got her up in the room under guard. Oh, he's still working the party. Acting smooth like nothing's nothing. So, buddy, I say we work a trade.
What do you mean?
Give him the clip. See, it's fucking brilliant. The tape for faith. I know he'll go for it and I can set it up.
This is what we laughingly refer to as a plan, right?
Hey, come on. Just get your butt down here, okay? If I'm not the party downstairs, go to the room. It's 2203, right?
2203.
If he gives us any shit, we'll kill them all. What do you say? We'll just get out of the pigeons.
Okay, we gotta get over there.
Did you borrow a dress from Cecile or something?
I'm not going.
What do you mean? We're going, Jan's gonna do it right there.
Liddy, park your mouth and listen. It's a setup. Think of it. Why is he sending tapes to you? To freak you? Get you to rush in without thinking? Put a bullet in you, wanting her and a gun in your hand?
Yeah, that sounds right. I'm going.
You gonna get yourself killed for this? Oh, for this toxic waste bitch?
What the fuck are you doing?
Look, this is your life. Right here, right now. It's real time. You hear me? Real time. Time to get real, not playback. You understand? She doesn't love you anymore. Maybe she did once, I don't know, but she doesn't now. These are used emotions. It's time to trade them in. Memories were meant to fade, Lenny. They're designed that way for a reason.
Have you ever been in love with someone who didn't return that love?
Yeah, Lenny.
It didn't stop you from loving them, right? Or being able to understand them or forgive them?
I guess.
Didn't stop you from wanting to protect them, did it? When I met Faith, she was just another runaway, getting $20 blowjobs to buy crack. That's another lost soul. And she had this voice that was... That was scary. Like she could take all the hurt and rage of the entire world and lift it up to heaven in one voice. I helped her. And I promised her that I'd always just be there to protect her. See, it's not about what's in her head, it's about what's in mine. I can't let go of the promise. It's like it's all I have left.
Come on. Let's go to a party.
But not
Cass got what I want. I've got what he wants.
This is the original. There are no copies.
Exactly. That's why it's a medical deal.
Look, this tape is a lightning bolt from God. It's worth more than you, more than me, and more than faith. You understand? It can change things. Things that need changing before we all go off the end of the road. And you do not have the right to use it for currency. So if you go, you go alone. You see, I care about you a lot more than you know, which makes us both pretty stupid, huh? But if you pawn this tape, you mean nothing to me.
That's the type of me farts on the dogs in here. Just one cop who's not dirty. It's him. Take it to him.
You want me to trust a cop?
No, trust me. Here.
What if you're wrong? Right now.
If it weren't New Year's Eve, I'd have you arrested for possession of illegal equipment.
Just look at the clip. You want to know who killed Jericho? You go into that stall right now and hit play.
Sir, is there a problem here?
Damn it, I knew it.
Come on,
let go of me.
Sir?
Wait, we talk here like two human beings. Nothing personal.
I didn't hear you come in.
Thank you.
virgin? Huh?
I love you, Max.
This is pretty fair.
Shit! Come here! Come here! Fuck, you wanna fucking die! You wanna fucking die! You wanna fucking die!
You hired me to kill you, baby! Can you believe that? Hey, never again!
Oh my god, I can't believe this is happening!
Believe it! I'm bringing the frozen to death! Come on, quick!
Come here, big shot. Suck on this, huh? Suck on this. You want to suck on this? Suck on this, huh?
What are you going to do? You can't just kill him, Max.
I'm not kill him. Give me that. I'm not going to kill him. Just a little post job.
You shut the fuck up! Shut up! Shut up! I'll pull this fucking trigger!
Fuck!
Here's how much I love you, baby.
God, Max.
Hope you enjoy the show, Philo.
Fuck. Take it, prick!
No, Max.
Don't make any assumptions about our friendship, okay, Lenny?
Didn't know you were colorblind, Max.
Only way you could stand your ties. Mano Cerebellico. Ooh. Glock 23. Nice.
Where's Faith?
Send her to the party. I figured I'd wait up here until you kill Gann.
What makes you think I'm gonna kill Gann?
You just did.
Jesus.
You know, statistically, that's the second most common word people say right before they die. Shit. Being number one.
So, I killed Gantt, and you ran in, being on his payroll, and shot me.
That's just about the way it happened.
Wait a minute, now I'm remembering. I killed Iris, too, didn't I?
That's right. They'll find the original first snuff clip in your apartment. The one I left for you at the club was a copy.
Was I a really busy guy? Did I do tick, too?
Oh, you bet. Did you like it?
So why, Max? Why did you have to do Iris?
Here, picture it. I feel like I gotta share this with somebody because it's just too perfect, okay?
Don't worry, I won't say anything.
Oh, I know. So I'm working for this puke, right? And he says he'll pay me quite large to do the hooker, but I also gotta do his bitch girlfriend because she knows the whole score and she's totally out of control. Only he doesn't know about me and Faith. So I say to myself, if I turn the job down, he just gets somebody else, and I lose Faith, to coin a phrase. So to buy some time, I do this gang, but I still gotta deal with Gant. I figure it's him or me, but I can't just camp him without some chump. Take the fall, and who better than his girlfriend's loser, ex-boyfriend, known criminal, and who has been seen half in the public numerous times.
And was regrettably also your best fucking friend.
Hey, no plan is perfect, Lenny. Come on, man, cheer up. Roll's gonna end in 10 minutes anyway.
You must be so pleased. I mean, I followed your chili bean trail right here like a good little chump.
You got frogging on me a couple times.
Oh?
Yeah, remember that riff about the death squad? That was pretty good. I had to keep from going to the cops.
I've heard stuff about a death squad.
The issue isn't whether you're paranoid, Lenny. I mean, look at this shit. The issue is whether you're paranoid enough.
So there never was a death squad?
No.
Just those two Wisconsin cops running around, covering their butts.
Pretty thing, huh? All this shit caused by a random traffic stop, huh? Ain't nothing means nothing, man. You know that. Look around, the whole planet's in total fucking chaos.
The day of reckoning is upon us!
You gotta get what you can, while you can, because some shit burden come put a 22 in the back of your head any second.
How'd you hook up with Faith?
This fuck hires me about a month ago to eyeball her. Only Faith knows me from you. So she comes up to me and says, Max, why are you following me? And I say, I'll buy you a drink. I'll explain. And then she says, so.
Do you enjoy watching me?
You're supposed to go downstairs, baby. Go downstairs.
I know. I don't always do exactly what I'm told, Max. You know that. So I said, do you enjoy watching me? Come on, Max. Play with me. And then what'd you say?
I said, yeah, I'd even do it for free.
Uh-huh. And I said, that's good, because I like the feeling of someone watching me. I acquired the taste from Lenny.
And then she said, since we're going to be spending so much time together, you know?
Why don't we make the best of it?
The very best. You know all about that, don't you, Lenny?
Faith and me, we found a place you could never reach, Max. Never. Faith, I know it's found. Even Max can't fucking touch it.
Enjoy it.
Please!
That's it. This woman some medical attention.
Thank you.
asked us a few questions for about 6 hours.
Okay, where are you, hurt, sir?
Ma'am, you okay? Ma'am?
Yeah. I need to get that coat off. Are you hurt anywhere else?
See you downtown.